Hey, programmers. You know how sometimes you've got a situation where you need to bring in information from multiple show files into one show file? Well, there's a lot of ways to do it, and the method that you choose depends on what you want to bring in. Today, I want to talk about just bringing in fixture and patch information. I'm Kat West. If you're new here, welcome to my channel, Consoletrainer, where I try to make some programming tasks a little easier to understand. If you want updates on when new videos come out, just click subscribe. One of the simplest ways to combine information is to use import-export. It's used so often, there's even an import-export menu in the settings window that allows you to combine things like macros and effects, but it doesn't include everything. Things like the patch have to be brought in through the command line. But don't worry, it's super quick and easy. There's really only one thing that could trip you up, but I'll show you how to get around that. The import that we're going to do is going to bring in fixture and channel IDs, patch information, their placement in 3D, basically all the stuff that you see in the patch window. So when would you use this import-export method? Well, you might use it if you need to combine patch information from two show files, but you don't want to go through the whole PSR process. Keep in mind, import-export will bring in almost everything about the fixtures from the patch window, but not anything related to programming like presets or cue lists. If you want all of that, then PSR, which stands for partial show read, is the way to go. I love PSR, but I know that it can be a little intimidating, so I've got another video coming up where we're gonna walk through it. Another reason that you'd use import-export is if you're using the MA2 Vectorworks plugin to bring the Vectorworks plot into your show file. Or maybe you just have XML information about the rig from another visualizer or any other program. If your layers are coming from another MA2 show file, load it up and take a look at the patch window. Select all of the layers that you want to export, and then hit Export Layers. From the pop-up, I'm going to pick my thumb drive, and I'm going to give it a name for this group of layers, something easy to remember like Festival. And we only need the XML file for what we're doing. So real quick, what does this export look like? Well, if you open up your thumb drive, look for the grandMA2 folder, and inside, find a folder called fixtures_layers. Inside there, you can find your file. It's just an XML. By the way, if you're bringing in information from another program, like maybe you're using the Vectorworks plugin and you chose the all in single layer option, this is the folder that you want to drop it into so that your console can read it. Okay, we're ready to import, so we need to load the show file that we're importing the fixtures to. If you're adding these layers to a show file that already has other fixtures in it, then first double check that you're not going to have any fixture ID or patch overlaps. If you don't do this beforehand, you can still import, but I always recommend cleaning this stuff up beforehand. Today though, I am going to break my own protocol and actually leave some known conflicts in just so you can see what it looks like. There's no button in the patch window that allows you to import the layers, so we have to do it from the command line. First, we need to tell the console where to look for this information, which is our thumb drive. You can do that from the command line, but I find it's quicker just to open up the backup window and select your thumb drive. Next, I want to expand my command line so that I can see what I'm typing. What we need to do is we need to get into the layer directory to import this. So to change directory, we're going to type CD for change directory, and then edit setup. Okay, so I know it's change destination, but my brain has just always thought of this as change directory. And apparently I can't stop. I mean, it's written right in front of me and I will say it wrong every time. Now, after you type that, your command line changes to the words edit setup. So our first deep dive into this has been successful. Next, I want to type CD layers. Okay, and now we're into the layers directory. Before I import this, I'm going to type list so that I can see what layers I already have in my show file. And I can see that there's 5. So when I import, I want my layers to start at 6 so that I'm not recording over what I already have. So now I'm gonna type import, and then in quotations, the name of my file, which is festival, at 6, please. And I can see there was 4 objects imported. That's a good sign. Now I need to dump out of the layers directory. So to do that, just type CD slash. Okay, so I want to take a look at the fixtures that I've imported. In my patch window, I can already see the new layers. But if we take a look at the festival JDCs, the patch information is in red text. Now, I told you there'd be a couple of things that are going to trip you up, and this is one of them. That red text is a very specific collision. Right now, there's 14 channels in between each address, and for a JDC1 in compressed mode, that would be okay. But if you take a look at the fixture type column, the console thinks this is a VL6000, which needs a lot more than 14 channels, thus the problem. Here's the deal. The grandMA2 organizes the fixture types in your show file using a number system, and these numbers are assigned chronologically based on when you add the profiles to your show file. Because of that, no two show files' fixture type numberings are ever going to line up. In my festival show, fixture type number 3 was a JDC1 compressed. In the show I'm imported to, fixture 3 is a VL6K. So we just have to fix this. While we're here, I want to mention that if you choose to bring in the patch via PSR, you're not going to run into this problem. Partial show read goes a lot more in depth. What we're doing here is basically just reading an XML file. Also, if you're using the Vectorworks plugin, there's actually a place where you'll assign these fixture type numbers before you export, so you also won't run into this problem. And I guess if you really wanted to go the long way, you could edit the XML file and update all your fixture types there, but I don't want to do that. Okay, I mentioned earlier that I was going to leave a couple of patch and ID number conflicts that you could see what happens. Well, let's take a look at our strip lights. I'm missing all of the fixture IDs and a lot of the patch. That's because these were the numbers that conflicted with something else that was already in my show file. Now, I can fix this now. It's not the end of the world, but I really recommend cleaning this stuff up before you do the import. Now that we've got everything imported and cleaned up, if I take a look at my stage view, I can see all my new festival fixtures. So that's it. That's our import-export. In the next couple of weeks, I want to talk about partial show read and even cloning in more detail. I hope you'll join me, and I hope that you're finding these videos helpful. See you soon.